We welcome you to Greensboro, North Carolina, where tonight young gymnasts from across the country are here to compete in the 2019 Nastia Lukin Cup. And just a few moments ago, the namesake and Olympic champ addressed the crowd here in Greensboro.
And now, please join us in welcoming your 2008 Olympic all-around gold medal champion for Team USA, the founder of the Nastia Lukin Cup, on the occasion of the 10th anniversary of this pivotal springboard event, Nastia Lukin.
Hi, everybody. I'm Nastia, and I wanted to welcome you all to the 10th annual Nastia Lukin Cup. I cannot believe that it has been a decade. I wanted to congratulate all of the athletes and the coaches for qualifying from all over the country to make it to this cup here today. And I've said this all weekend long, and I'm going to say it again. You are all the best of the best in the very best country in the world. So I wish you the best of luck tonight, and I can't wait to watch you shine.
NBC Sports welcomes you to the 2019 Nastia Lukin Cup. Crowd inside the Greensboro Coliseum, a center that has been around since the 1950s, some great events through the years, including for many years the ACC Basketball Tournament, Final Four, Figure Skating Championships, Gymnastics Championships. Here we are again. Welcome, everybody. Terry Gannon, along with the Olympic champs, Nastia Lukin and Tim Daggett. First thing first, congratulations, 10 years. It was your vision, and now here it is 10 years later.
Yeah, it's still kind of mind-blowing to know that, you know, when you can create something and actually see it come to life, and not just once, but 10 years later. And for me, it was really just about giving these young ladies that opportunity to compete on a big stage just like we did at the Olympic Games, and to feel like they're really more than just themselves, that they're really part of something, and that's why they're all wearing matching leotards, which you'll get into, Tim.
Young athletes from across the country, you may not know their names right now. Eventually, though, some of them you will very well. Tonight, not one, but two different competitions, Tim.
Absolutely. There is a senior competition and a junior. Seniors will be wearing a black leotard tonight, and for them, what an opportunity to compete in a world-class stage on a podium, and they're going to take that with them. Most of them have already committed to universities all across America to do their gymnastics. The juniors tonight, they'll be wearing pink leotards, and I'll tell you what, historically, there have been many that have gone on to tremendous international success. Case in point, three-time Olympic gold medalist Gabby Douglas.
And that name and some other ones, too. For more on them, we bring in the fourth member of our crew and a four-time U.S. all-around champ, John Roethlisberger. John?
Thanks, Terry. It is great to be here for the 10th anniversary of the Nastia Lukin Cup Finals. This is a competition that has been a big-screen debut of sorts for some American gymnasts that have gone on to international greatness. Tim, you just mentioned the most notable name, Gabby Douglas. She was here for the inaugural Nastia Lukin Cup in 2010. And on this floor, she made her big screen debut, as we said, and she finished just off the podium in fourth place at that competition. It is hard to believe that this young woman, when she made her appearance here just a little over 2 years later, would go on to win the Olympic all-around gold medal and become one of the greatest American gymnasts in history. But there's more, and who could forget the next young lady? Little Morgan Hurd was just 12 years old when she came to the Nastia Lukin Cup Finals at the time. She's one of the best level 10 gymnasts in the country, but she went on to 2017 World Championships after finishing 14th at this competition, won the world all-around title. In addition to Gabby and Morgan Hurd, Michaela Skinner, Maggie Nichols were world champions, as well as Ashton Locklear, who was a world champion, as well as an alternate on the 2016 Olympic team. Terry?
John, thanks. So the seniors and the juniors tonight, you guys think back. I know for one of you it's a long time ago, but prior to the big accomplishments at the Olympics, at World Championships, you still do remember these type of events when you come through.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I never competed in this competition, but these are the moments that you do remember. Of course, you remember the World Championships, the Olympic Games, but, you know, sometimes it's these competitions that you kick off your career, like we saw from Gabby Douglas, Morgan Hurd. It was one of the first times that they've competed in a big arena under bright lights on a podium-style competition, which really does a lot of difference. Everything's elevated, a lot more bounce on the floor, a lot of stuff to get used to.
That does change some things, right? When you come out here, you're in this arena,
and with this crowd, knowing there are cameras here?
Absolutely. I mean, if you look around on the floor, this feels just like a World Championships or even an Olympic Games. You know, we mentioned Morgan Hurd. I'll tell you what, that photo of her was so tiny and has gone on to become just a staple of USA Gymnastics, winning that all-around title in 2017. And I'll tell you what, there are some tremendous athletes on this floor here tonight.
All right, so we started off on beam with a 15-year-old from Kenosha, Wisconsin, Faith Torres. And you've already talked in our meetings and just watching about her and how good she is going to be.
She is yikes good. I'll tell you, she has already qualified as what's called an elite. She'll compete at the national championships alongside Simone Biles, Morgan Hurd. And it all gets crazy right away. Her start is a back with a full, and I've never seen a gymnast be as consistent in training on that skill right there. That is off the charts difficult. Great series right there.
Three skills in a row just makes it so much more difficult when you connect, like she was trying to do right there, connect these two elements in a row, which you'll get bonus for. Didn't quite get it there, but on the first connection, did beautifully.
Everywhere I watched her in the training session, I was blown away. Her power on floor, tremendous. Gonna do a double back here from a round off. Great power, just a small hop on the landing. She is tremendous.
And you know, for Faith, this is a great competition for her to get some experience as she goes into the national championships, because this is exactly what that arena will look like, the same exact setup.
Third in the all-around last year at the Nastia Lukin Cup, which was held just outside of Chicago.
So you go to a World Championships or an Olympic Finals and you see skills of this magnitude being performed.
And just like you said, that was a very difficult skill. Same as the dismount. These are dismounts that we are seeing at the World Championships, at the Olympic Games. Round off, double back tuck. You see her spot the landing with her eyes. Not quite a stick, but definitely a great routine, especially starting out on the balance beam. That's always nice to get that under your belt.
Wearing black, so part of the senior competition. The juniors in pink, as Tim said tonight. 15-year-old from Wisconsin, Faith Torres, who I'd be willing to bet you will hear quite a lot from her in the future.
And she's actually capable of doing even much more difficulty.
So what about the number now, 9.725 for Bean?
Well, that's the thing, you take the big risks like she did, and sometimes you lose a little bit, but I think it was a great decision on her part to go for it all.
So we take you over to the bars. 17-year-old from Texas, Kaya Johnson, set to go. Senior in high school, eventually going to LSU.
Trains with Olympic and world all-around great Kim Zemeskal and her husband, Chris Burdett.
You know, it was so fun. As you mentioned, she's going to LSU this morning. I had a brunch with all of the athletes, and this is kind of my time to get to know them a little bit, and they were all so excited to share, you know, their next journey, where they'll be going to college.
The major competition for a lot of these young ladies is the Junior National Olympic Champions, and she was at the top of the heap. She won the all-around in her age group and classification in 2018.
That was great. Not a lot of deduction there, and that is exactly what the judges are going to be looking for, especially, and we'll talk about this a little bit more, but the scoring system, you'll see it's out of a 10.0, which we are not using on the elite system here, but because this is the level 10 rules here, the JO program, and they're going to be very nitpicky all night long. I can imagine that it's going to come down to, like it always does every single year, the all-around will come down to by possibly less than a tenth of a point.
The hardest way to flip in gymnastics is when you keep your body in a laid-out position. So you're straight as a board, makes it harder to get it all the way around, but she had zero problem with that.
Is that the Lucan Cup back in 2014, 15, and last year? Hoffman Estates, where she came in fifth in the all-around. Looking for better than that this time around here in Greensboro as we continue our coverage here. We'll wait for her number, but again, this a big weekend, a big week in Greensboro. So many of the top athletes, and this night all about the young gymnasts from around the country trying to break through on a national stage here at the 2019 Nastia Lucan Cup. Back at the Nastia Lucan Cup, 9.625 for the uneven bars for Kaya Johnson, the 17-year-old from Texas. We're about to take you over to floor, and Natalie Martin set to go. For more on her, we check in with John.
For Natalie Martin, this competition has an even greater importance. You see, Natalie's dad, Tim, is unable to attend this weekend because he is in an incredible fight against cancer. And for a moment, there was a time when Natalie and her mom, Joanne, were questioning whether they would even be able to come this weekend. But Natalie's dad, Tim, looked at him and said, "You got to do it. I want you to go, and I want you to experience the Nastia Lucan Cup, something that you've always dreamed of." So here she is with so much pressure on her and so many things running through her mind. I can't imagine how tough it is for this young lady to get on the floor, but this is quite an inspirational moment for her.
Thoughts of her dad as she is ready to compete here in Greensboro. Westerville, Ohio, 13 years of age.
Yeah, what a hard decision to make, but I'm sure that her dad, as John said, really wanted her to be here. What an opportunity for her.
Buckeye Gymnastics, which was, you guys talked about Gabby Douglas. Gabby Douglas's gym, now set on floor.
There, beautiful stuck, double back dismount. Happy for this young lady.
I'm watching back home. So the 13-year-old with that initial effort here in Greensboro on floor.
Down.
Good job.
Good
job.
Yes.
So from the eighth grader, we take you over to Beam and Andrea Lee, 18 years of age from Aurora, Illinois. Her sister you may know, Anna, who was an alternate on that 2012 Olympic team for the U.S. Parents were so successful as gymnasts as well. There is Anna, sister and coach now, and here we go.
Yeah, long line of gymnastics, as you said, Terry. Mom and dad both, 1984. Olympic medalists, Wu Jiani and Li Weizhou, tremendous athletes. Anna followed suit, and now she is helping out. They own their own gymnastics center in Illinois.
Andy is just such a beautiful gymnast when you watch her, the artistry, the grace, flexibility.
Gorgeous.
We'll see more on the uneven bars where she's great too, just like her sister Anna was.
Tell you what though, the Nastia Lukin Cup, you really can't have any major mistakes and come out with the title. So far, this very clean exercise. Dismount, double full, small hop on the landing, but a very strong start.
But as you said, Tim, it literally, I think every single year has come down to maybe even less than a tenth of a point, and it's little hops like that on the dismount. Sisterly love here.
Or coaching, stern coaching.
Yeah.
A little bit of both. And here's that dismount. So she does a little bit of an easier dismount than we saw from Faith. Just a double twist, so one flip, two twists, little cross legs in the air, some deduction there, as well as that slight hop.
The reaction from the big sis. Good job.
There's the love there. From third to second, who knows this time around here at the Nastia Lukin Cup. Yes, we are mentioning the event as often as possible, as directed by our cohort. Checks in the mail, hopefully. Natalie Martin saw that floor routine, 9.150 for the 13-year-old.
Maybe a little harsh, huh, Nastia?
Yeah, I would definitely say so.
Just the mount, she had a little bit of a wobble on, but.
But stuck landings on,
yeah,
on the other two.
Andrea Lee waiting for the number over on balance beam. There it is, 9.725 for her, so right in the mix right there. So next we're gonna have Daisha Cannon, the 13-year-old. John, do you have more?
You know, the World Champions Center has a contingent of four athletes here, the largest contingent of any gym at this competition. As you also may know, that is where the great Simone Biles trains. And when you get to train with the great Simone Biles, you also get things like this.
Hey, WCC girls. I've been watching you guys for the past couple weeks train really, really hard for the Nastia Cup. Good luck. Have fun. I'll be rooting for you and watching you. I love you, girls.
They have got a great group of kids here at this competition. I had a chance to talk with them a little bit yesterday and what it's like to train with Simone Biles. And young Lily looked at me and said, you know, one day I was having a real tough time. I wasn't making a skill. And then Simone came over, gave me some advice. And the next turn, I made it. So look out, coaches. Simone Biles might be a coach as well.
That's a pretty nice edge to have. The greatest
magic,
ever.
You know,
yeah, the absolute greatest of all time, the GOAT, Simone Biles. And I think, John, I had that same impact on you, didn't I, during your career?
Wait, they cut his mic. He can't answer.
Yeah, Tim, you're breaking up, buddy. Sorry. Can you repeat that? Absolutely, Tim Daggan, and I'm not even joking. I grew up watching you, and absolutely.
There is the coach right there, Cecile Landy.
She and Laurent, coaches of Simone Biles as well. So the 13-year-old now in Spring, Texas, born in North Carolina, Camp Lejeune. Thank you.
That was a great start, especially as we mentioned, you see she's in the pink leotard, so she is one of our juniors competing here. What a great experience for her to be able to come out here, gain a lot of experience as she moves towards her career.
Deja Cannon, eighth grade homeschool. Looking at the bios, it gets depressing. Her graduation year for high school, 2023. Oh. Back with the action here at the Nastia Lukin Cup, just to give you a little guide here, guys, on what is good, what is great, perfect, excellent.
Well, as you can see, the 10.0, perfect. And, you know, to be completely honest, I'd love to see that tonight.
There you go.
It being the 10th anniversary, why not, right? And then, of course, you see excellent. So basically, one very minor error, a wobble on the beam. So 9.975 to a 9.7, then good 2 to 3 minor errors, and then average, of course, below a 9.3 or below.
So with that in mind, we look at the number for Deja Cannon, 9.4.
And, you know, these scores are obviously different than you're going to see at the Olympic Games, which has an open code so they can get, you know, 15s and plus. The one caveat to that scoring is on vaulting, some of the gymnasts will be doing a vault that actually in the junior program is valued at a 10.1.
Yep.
Will it look true when that's the case?
Move on to the next floor exercise, and it's Makari Doggett. This event's been around for 10 years. She's making her 6th appearance at the Nastia Lukin Cup. And for many reasons, but one very good reason, right?
Yes. The leotards, right?
Yeah.
No, it was so much fun being able to design these leotards, and every single year, too. This is the big reveal.
Wow.
She said it was the best ever, just in case you didn't hear, but.
That's a good dance you had going on, too.
You know, just a little bit.
Celebration.
Can you teach me that after?
Maybe. Nice.
I'll be gone before that. 18 years of age from Ohio. Here is Makari Doggett, a veteran here at the Nastia Lukin Cup, headed to the University of Alabama.
2017-2018 J.O. National All-Around Champion, has a lot of titles.
And she knows the drill to this competition. It was actually really cool this morning at the brunch, and I was asking how many, you know, first-timers that we had at the Nastia Lukin Cup, and there were a lot of hands raised. And then, of course, you have her, and it's her 6th time. I'm like, okay, well, you're going to be the 2nd Nastia, basically, this week, and if anyone needs something, anyone needs advice, you know exactly what to tell them.
Yeah, the Nastia Lukin Cup is not just a competition. There are so many other things that go on. You have different gatherings with them.
Yeah, and that to me was really important, because obviously it's great to put on a great competition, but I wanted to get to know these young ladies, and I, more importantly, wanted them to get to know me, the real me, not just the Olympian that they saw on the balance beam, or, you know, if they follow me on social media, just truly get to know me as a person.
The other aspect, too, we say she's come back 6 times, and you've got to earn your way here. There are invitationals that take place across the country, so these are the best of the best.
Absolutely. 18 invitationals all across the country, and it is not easy to qualify, because you have to win. One junior, one senior from each of these qualifying events qualify here. So you can imagine how difficult that is when there are so many great level 10 athletes all across the country.
And Terry, the Tim Daggett National Invitational has never been one of those invitationals.
Well, have you applied?
It's an outrage. It really is. So the worst part for an athlete, the wait to start, and they have computer issues. Yep, modern technology.
It is the absolute worst thing in the world, because you know, everything is choreographed. Your coach's last words to you, the walk over to the chalk bucket, you know, the rolling out of the ankles a certain amount of time, and this throws a wrench in that. The veterans, like her, have to be able to deal with that, and she's certainly gonna have to be able to deal with that when she goes on to college.
If you were waiting right now, would you walk away and start some of that routine again?
Absolutely.
Oh, I wouldn't.
No?
No, I would have,
yes. It's a superstition thing for me. Like, if I've done my routine once, I'm not going to go through it again.
One thing that I always told my athletes is, if this happens to them, you go back, you chalk up again, and they made you wait. You have to go in a reasonable amount of time, but you make them wait when it's your time to go.
But this truly is the worst thing, especially on an event like balance beam, when it's already nerve-wracking enough, but
yeah.
Any event, really.
Yeah. So we go over to vault. They are ready. Sierra Brooks, the 17-year-old from Plainfield, Illinois. Power.
A big power. And that is that caveat that I spoke about, this vault, because she did 1.5 twists, is valued out of a 10.1. She's got a lot of errors on the landing, though. As you'll see here, great power, huge bounce off that table. If she just did a full, it would be worth a 10, but because she adds that second half, 10.1, she's outside the lines, which is a deduction, and two big steps as well. But she's got two vaults, and in this competition, what they do is they don't average them, they take the better score of the two vaults, and she's certainly hoping to have a better landing on this one.
So 9.55, and here you go again.
There you go.
And that was much better, so much more controlled, smaller step on that landing, and that's the one she is most definitely going to take.
You would think so. We'll get that number in a moment. Meanwhile, they are set for the floor exercise now. Akari Doggett, the 18-year-old from Ohio. Doggett, whose mom was a gymnast for West Virginia, and her older sister Brooklyn committed to compete for West Virginia. She's headed to Alabama.
Huge power, tremendous air and height on her tumbling passes. And in the elite level, you can take it, you can't take a step back in the JO program. After you land, step back, no deduction.
Uneven bars, 15-year-old Ava Pedrajeda from Ellersburg, Maryland. Freshman in high school and committed to Penn State.
Freshman in high school and committed.
Yep, that's how it goes these days.
It does. Really nice release there.
My favorite skills, the pack salto.
Love it too. Trains at Hills Gymnastics. Kelly Hill, the coach, longtime coach. So many tremendous gymnasts herself. Dominique Dawes. Oh, wow. There you go. Gymnastics 101. Fly high and stick the landing.
I was waiting for that one.
First opportunity to get that in tonight.
Hey. Some folks have been giving me a hard time saying that I need to have a 201 and a 301. We'll stick with this. Look at her hips, how high they are. Above the bar. Wow.
Super difficult. I'm being very nitpicky. A little sloppy on that back end, those knees, but the dismount was just beautiful. She got super high in the air. So double back with a full twist. You see her spot the ground like that? That's exactly what you're supposed to do.
Bam. Good stuff.
Through a wow, a bam, and a 101.
A lot going on here in this bar, too.
Yes. She loves it, too. Kari Doggett, 9.575 for that floor exercise.
That is surprising to me.
Tim and I just looked at each other because I thought that was a little low.
From right here in Greensboro, you see it on your screen, a 14-year-old, Gabby Gladio.
Yeah, that's got to be awesome to do this here. Remember, she's from Greensboro, but she had to qualify at an invitational somewhere across the country, 18 different competitions. Nice series there, really clean and greatly executed and landed. Has a really nice look on balance beam, really good carriage with her body, nice knees and toes.
Just the dismount right here.
Wow.
That was really, really great.
Excellent. I was talking with one of our producers here, and I said, go ahead, Nastia, sorry.
Oh, no, it's okay. There's that connection. So switch leap to a back tuck, her shoulders. You see, the judges are looking for your shoulders to be up on that landing, and she did that so well.
Really nice dismount. A lot of gymnasts kind of fade off the balance beam. She explodes, gets really nice air on the dismount. And that technically is probably not a stick, but in my book, that's zero deductions on that landing.
So you'd be a nice judge.
I would.
You're not always nice on air, but apparently you'd be a nice judge.
Beatrice Hita, 9.625 uneven bars. Think it should have been higher?
I think that was actually pretty fair on a few form breaks. As I kind of mentioned in the replay, you saw huge release move, but when she caught the bar, her knees, her toes,
a little bit.
In the dismount, even though it was a stuck landing, just in the air, just very little things, very minor things, but that is what the judges are looking for every single second of the routine.
You want a little perspective on this competition?
Gladio, 9.725.
There are so many unbelievable gymnasts in the United States right now looking at this field and what they're capable of doing, not what they're actually doing here today. I think you could put together five gymnasts, go to the World Championships in 2019, and get on the podium, get a bronze medal. USA first, Russia second, Team B for, or Team
Team Nastia.
Team Nastia.
Totally kidding.
That's a huge statement, though. I mean, that is significant. Tom Forster would love to hear that, the high performance team coordinator.
And his wife, Lori, right next to them, longtime gym club owners in Colorado. Now he is in charge of the program.
But to be that deep as a program, we know about all the success of the USA women recently and just been pretty dominant for a number of years now. But the future, as good as that or even better?
Certainly as good. I don't know how you could get better than the way the U.S. women have been over the last 10 years or so.
Deeper, I guess, is what I'm saying. To make that statement you just did, that I mean, you're going to the young ages right now.
Absolutely.
Thinking about what we saw from Gladio a moment ago, yes, it's an advantage being at home. It's great being home. It's a thrill. A lot of pressure here, too.
Oh, certainly. I mean, anytime you're competing on such a big stage, there's pressure already. And then, even in the march out earlier tonight when her name was called, this entire arena was, I'm pretty sure, 90% of the people are here for her.
And
it's pretty awesome, but definitely a lot of pressure.
Lindsay Batchelor, a 15-year-old from not too far away, right down the road in Raleigh. Sophomore, Crossroads Flex High School. Started back in 2008, so 11 years ago, and yes, she's 15 years old now.
And you know, it is different. Like you were saying, the lights, the applause, but also this competition is on what's called a podium, just like you would see at a World Championships or an Olympic Games. That is big time stuff. And that changes the equipment dramatically on floor exercise. The floor is a little bit more bouncy. You get a little bit more air because it's kind of got a second little floor. It's a floor exercise mat sitting on something that has a little bounce as well.
Just psychologically too, you're up here. I mean, you are exposed.
Oh, and then imagine being on a beam.
Yeah.
You know, that's even higher. It's a little scary, I'm not gonna lie.
But you liked it on a podium, right, Nastia?
I liked doing floor and vault on a podium.
I didn't like doing bars
and beam.
Well, yeah.
It's a little too high.
And the bars.
It has a different bounce and a different swing to it when it is on a podium, and it's really difficult to kind of get that right feeling because the tightness of the bars, it's a huge adjustment for sure.
So here is Lindsay Batchelor.
Another great floor routine.
They've been tight so far on floor, though.
Said she tried everything as a kid, little kid, horseback riding, soccer, swimming, dance. Eventually, gymnastics took hold. And on the national stage, Lindsay Batchelor, the 15-year-old from Raleigh, as we continue. After the first rotation here in the 2019 Nastia Lukin Cup, Jillian Hoffman in the lead, but Faith Torres, we saw her. Andrea Lee, very good, and sharing second place as we send it over and check in with John again.
Thanks, Terry. This event, without a doubt, is a showcase for the future stars of collegiate gymnastics, as we've talked about. And it's very likely that if you're a fan of these athletes, you'll be able to follow them throughout their collegiate career because women's collegiate gymnastics is exploding nationwide. Case in point, Caitlin Ohashi from UCLA. She is an outstanding gymnast for the Bruins, and her floor routine earlier this season went viral. And when I say viral, over 40 million views on social media, and you can see the crowd behind her. Makari Daggett, she will be going to Alabama next season. She signed with them earlier this year. She said that she has been anxious to get there for a long time. And meanwhile, Sierra Brooks, she will be going to Michigan. And over half of the athletes competing on the floor today have already committed to universities, and they are going to be competing in front of crowds of 10,000 plus. In fact, four universities across the country are averaging over 10,000 fans in the stands every time they compete. It's big time now, and you'll get a chance to watch them for years to come. When we come back, we got a lot more gymnastics. Rotation 2 back at the Nastia Lukin Cup Finals.
Back in Greensboro, the 2019 Nastia Lukin Cup continues. Terry Gannon, along with the namesake, and Tim Daggett and John Roethlisberger. So the young stars of tomorrow on the national stage tonight. The 16-year-old Madeline Johnston from Maryland was born in Washington, D.C., junior in high school, and yes, junior, so she's committed late, I guess, to Penn State.
Crazy, right? Yeah, it's amazing in the club world where all of these young ladies train, how early the college coaches are looking at them. There are obviously some rules in place to make sure that they aren't too much of a distraction. But I'll tell you what, it starts so young.
And such a high percentage of those that we are watching have committed already.
Yeah,
or at least know where they're going.
They absolutely have. And, you know, it's kind of scary to make that kind of decision at such a young age, thinking this is what I want to do, you know, when I'm graduating high school, years and years down the road.
Of course, you can change. I mean, you haven't signed anything at that point. You're a freshman in high school.
Right.
You've committed. You haven't signed.
You haven't, but I tell you what, the vast majority, way vast majority, end up following through and going where they had committed to.
There are others, obviously, who we've watched at the Olympics at a very young age who have not gone on to college. So it's whatever works for you, whatever the situation is best for you. But college athletics, gymnastics has really gotten, as John just talked about with the crowds now.
It has exploded. Yeah. Oh, absolutely. And,
I mean, even 10, 15 years ago when I was making that decision of what I wanted to do, it was just at a whole different level. And of course, for me, it was a lot of things came into play into my decision. My dad, obviously, being my coach, couldn't imagine being coached by anybody else, to be completely honest. But it really was at a different level than it is now.
And there he is.
Speaking of.
And that's not just her dad. There you see it right there. Four-time Olympic medalist. If you're to poll a lot of the gymnasts around the world, many of them will say that Valeri Lukin was their idol, their hero.
Certainly was mine.
That is a very big deduction. You grab the balance beam, super challenging element. Maybe doesn't look as hard as some of those aerial skills, but a double turn on beam, really hard.
And you know, that's what we always talk about pretty much on every single event, but especially on the balance beam, the risk reward. When you're doing these difficult skills, you're then risking getting more deduction than it's even worth.
Yeah, my guess is she doesn't need to do that element. It's just she probably really likes it.
And she probably never really has a huge mistake like that in practice.
Yeah, see, there are some skills, though, that are really easy to do in practice and are never easy in a competition, and that's one of them.
Add on nerves, that extra adrenaline that you have, the extra energy, and a lot of times that's what happens.
Double back, had to straddle her legs a little bit in the air. That means she's grabbing her knees and pulling them apart. It's a bit of a deduction, not as aesthetic. But beyond that grabbing of the beam, overall a pretty good job. So watch, two complete times around on the beam. Just had a little bit too much rotation. So she wants to finish facing exactly forward. Watch right here. She goes a little bit past, as you can see, reaches down and grabs the beam.
Here's that dismount. So round off, double back. So two flips in the air. Just doesn't quite get that punch off of the beam. You see her shoulders, her chest down a little too low. Definitely, and of course, the step on the landing. So going to be a pretty major deduction there on that dismount.
Beam's deceptive, too, watching from the outset. Some of the moves, as you mentioned, are much more difficult than other ones, which look spectacular.
Yeah.
It's deceiving.
Yeah.
Get the number from Madeline Johnston, which she won't love, 9.325.
Yeah, you really need to be in the 9.7 or above range here on all the events, most likely to factor in to the podium finish.
Over to bars and Sage Thompson, the 16-year-old from Utah. Sophomore at Sky Ridge High School, headed to Cal. John?
Pal Terry. She's also going to be teammates with Andrea Lee there at Pal. And I watched Sage Thompson and all the girls do bars yesterday. And I'll tell you what, Sage, she jumped off the mat. She is outstanding on this event. And I'll tell you what, the Cal Bears, they're going to be formidable in the years to come with both of these young ladies on their bar team.
Big release, connected.
Beautiful.
Gorgeous release, and then connected down to the low. See, this is an example. This routine isn't hard enough, but by the skill she's doing, I can tell she could do an elite level routine.
Wow.
Wow.
You know, and of course, Sage says that bars is her favorite event. It's often, for some people, the hardest event because, in my opinion, it doesn't always translate to the other events that are the leg, powerful events like the floor exercise, the ball, even the balance beam.
Sage Thompson, the 16-year-old from Utah, a family of nine. You know the siblings watching the action tonight from the Greensboro Coliseum, flying high here as we roll on at the Nastia Lukin Cup. Back to the 10th edition of the Nastia Lukin Cup. Second time that it's taken place here in Greensboro inside the Coliseum. Over to floor and Andrea Lee, the 18-year-old from the Chicago area.
Tied for second place in the all-round after one. Routine. Very well done. Once again, her sister, Anna. And I'll tell you what, for the Lees, execution and beautiful form is a family affair. As you'll see, this double pike somersault, and look at the straight legs, beautiful toes in the air, little bit of lack of control on the landing, though.
And sometimes that comes from having enough power. And as you see right here, 2.5 twist at the end. Really difficult, especially that blind landing. Can't quite see the ground, but the little bitty legs crisscross in the air.
But I'll tell you what, that was a veteran right there, because she was moving towards stepping out of bounds for sure. She made a correction, looked down at the floor, and stayed in bounds.
9.55 for Lee, who, as I mentioned, came in second and third the last couple of times here at the Nastia Lukin Cup, but also won the junior competition back in 2016. All right, over to Gabby Wilson now. We keep it right here on floor. 17 years of age from Ypsilanti, Michigan. And she had the highest qualifying score overall for this competition.
An astronomical 39.25 in the all-around. Yikes.
Thank you.
Once again, another great floor exercise. So much power in all of those tumbling passes, and not just the power you can't control, but all of her landings were so well controlled. It's like she knew exactly where she was in the air, which sometimes is a little bit difficult, especially when you don't have as much experience as we talk about on the podium. Here's that opening tumbling pass, which again, we have seen at a World Championships and an Olympic Games, a double back with a full twist, and she doesn't even grab her legs.
Absolutely.
It makes it that much more difficult because her hands are not even touching her legs.
Shades of Simone Biles. That's how Simone does it, and she's the best in the world. Another tumbling run right here, front somersault into a double back. Really nice, but I'll tell you what, floor so far today has been really tightly scored.
Gonna stay home for college, Ann Arbor area, gonna go to the University of Michigan.
Scored a 9.45 on her first event, 9.65 on her first event, the balance beam. And this is a big one.
There you go, 9.65 here.
On floor.
So very well done and received for Gabby Wilson. Sure, sixth place after that opening rotation. Here's the 17-year-old from Christiansburg, Virginia, Raina Worley.
Judges.
Did she actually smile and nod at you after the
pass? I think we made some eye contact there.
Wow. Judges better give it up here. Incredible tumbling, great landing. There's not a college program in the country that wouldn't like that to be part of their repertoire.
Just earned her way here a few days ago, too, at the Greater Greensboro Invitational. Terrific from Raina Worley. Back with a number for Raina Worley. You expected a high one. You got it.
Absolutely.
Finally, that was tremendous, though. I'm glad the judges left a little room because that was better than everybody else.
She likes performing, too. She up there on floor right now afterwards, that nod and a smile to you, presence of mind to do that.
Maybe. I mean, I'm definitely going to ask her.
I think it was to you, Terry, actually.
Well, you know, it's funny. Today, all day, I really just told them, you have done so much to just qualify to this competition. I want you all to go out there and just have fun. And that's exactly what she did.
Think about earning your way here, too, what she just went through a couple of days ago.
Yeah.
Everybody else pretty much has had, you know, some weeks, some months even to kind of recover and get ready for this, not her.
7+7. Got a moment? We'll send it over to John.
Yeah, Nastia, I just wanted to piggyback on what you just said about having fun at this competition. If you look around the sidelines, these competitors, they want to come here and win, but it's like a college meet. All these girls are standing up, they're watching everybody's performance, they're cheering each other on. It's like they're as invested in each other's performances as they are their own. It's pretty cool to see.
And you know, college programs are aware of where they're going and are watching and doing the same. watching on TV.
When a lot of times there might be some college coaches sitting here, maybe not because they're in the middle of the season, but they're definitely watching.
There are a few, I'm sure of that.
Sure of 11th after that first rotation. Time, though, for 18-year-old Hallie Thompson now.
Started on balance beam. Had a 9.6 on that event. Solid start.
Judges something.
They are. You know, we've talked about the high level of difficulty that these athletes are capable of doing. This right here, a triple full, first time we've seen it on air tonight. This is a world or international class element. Back somersault three times around. Yes, the legs were a little bit apart, but a tremendous triple full there.
And if we're being really picky, maybe slightly under-rotated, those three twists, but as you said, very difficult skill.
Senior at Charlotte Latin School, about an hour and a half from here in Charlotte. Hallie Thompson, 9.475. And over to uneven bars, and Abby Thompson in fourth share of it after that first rotation, 17-year-old in Sanford, Florida.
Orlando Metro Gymnastics and head coach, you see him in the background there, Jeff Wood, has put just a boatload of athletes into the NCAA program. One of his best, Shayla Worley, a world champion in the team event.
I was going to say, and not just the NCAA program, but the national team. One of those coaches and gyms that really have produced so much and been around this scene for so long.
A little bit of a character, too.
So a junior at the Masters Academy, heading to the University of Denver, Abby Thompson.
Here's the end of her routine, the dismount. So we've seen a lot of different dismounts. We've seen a double layout, which two flips, and you want to see your full body stretched. Here she does the first one with her hips open and then closes her hips into a pike position. But a solid routine. You know, a lot of times for these athletes, and I've kind of mentioned it before, but bars is one of those routines in the events that you just kind of want to get through for a lot of them, depending on what your favorite, where your strengths are, and probably not necessarily her strongest event, but had a great routine there.
Yeah, because bars is not like floor, vaulting, or even balance beam, which are all tumbling events. It's a swinging event. Very, very different.
Requires such a different skill set.
Keeping up and trying to keep pace with the numbers and who's leading and whatnot, it does skew that as well, and what our normal high scores on each apparatus. So having completed that opening rotation and now significantly into the second rotation, you still, you look up, you go, well, it depends on what I have left. John, what do you have?
You know, we're getting ready to see Cassie Stevens on bars, and one of the greatest thrills for these coaches is getting their athletes onto a college team and a college scholarship. And Dan Wittenstein, the coach of Cassie Stevens, said exactly that. He said, I've spent almost half of Cassie's life with her, coaching her, and it's a thrill to see her go off to college, but it's also heartbreaking to have her move on. But it's part of their life, part of club coaching's what they do.
Underway here on bars.
Yeah, it is. It is such a double-edged sword. Without a doubt, I've done it many times as a coach. So happy for them and the success that they had as a junior gymnast, but kind of hard to let them go, too.
Well, the amount of hours that you're spending in the gym, it truly becomes a family. You know, with your teammates, you become sisters. With your coaches, it really is. It becomes a family effort, and you go through great times together. You go through difficult times, such as injuries and obstacles, and it's always great being able to have moments like these.
Cassie Stevens celebrating a birthday this weekend, 18 years of age. All right, Faith Torres, we saw her open up early in the show over on Beam, the 15-year-old now on floor.
Yeah, she was second, as you can see right here, but she didn't have the best routine she can do. This is another fantastic opportunity for her. She will start the routine off with a ginormous double laid out somersault, so her body is completely stretched throughout two flips. And I'll tell you, I've seen very few elite level gymnasts on the world stage do this as effortlessly and beautifully as this young lady right here. Do it right off the top, her first tumbling run. That mat that she'll be landing on, that is legal and not a deduction at this competition. Fabulous. I'll tell you what, she has a lot of qualities that the world's best have. She is so powerful. The mount that she does, double laid out somersault, this almost looks Simone Biles' height in the air. Just watch how high her body, it keeps going up on the second flip, makes it around easy. Judges, you gotta reward that. You better, you should.
Well, the last time you said that, they did. So maybe they got a mic, can hear you. Faith Torres, the 15-year-old in eighth grade. Cassie Stevens, there's the number on the uneven bars, 9425. So take you over to Kaya Johnson on Beam now. In 10th place after that opening rotation. When she started on bars, you think about what we were just talking about, that rotation, what you have left and where you can make up some ground.
Yeah, and she can absolutely make up some ground on the remaining events. But you really want to get this one over with, no matter when you do it.
What was the hardest position for you, Nastia?
terms of the rotation?
Yeah, for you, starting.
Because bars was my strongest event, I liked getting that one over with. You know, I knew if I had a slight mistake, any minor mistake on the uneven bars, it totally took me out of contention.
There we go, first major test. Gorgeous flip-flop layout, step out. Really solid front flip. She's very confident in all of her skills, and that is so critical. You see a gymnast get up on the balance beam and they doubt themselves just a little bit. You end up seeing all these tiny wobbles and little balance checks right there is definitely something she didn't plan on doing.
She's sure. Going to connect those two leaps, the one at the beginning and the end. But she was smart because you have to connect two leaps in a row in your routine. And because she missed that connection, she actually added in a third leap, and so now she won't have that deduction.
Double twist, little slide on the landing, just that small hiccup in the middle there, but overall, pretty good routine.
Closing out this second rotation, Kaya Johnson on beam after the bars and where she opened up, the number for Faith Torres, 9725. You got it, it's high.
A good number.
Not as high as the previous one you called for, but on we go to the third rotation. Through two rotations, that's how we stand here. Raina Worley was terrific a few moments ago. Faith Torres then with the number she got. Makari Doggett, a 9.85, that second rotation on vault, a very high number. So we continue our coverage here as we send it over to John Roethlisberger with a special guest now.
Thanks, Terry. I'm here with Tom Forrester. He prefers Grand Poobah, but officially it's the National High Performance Team Coordinator. Tom, what do you think so far? We're here at the 10th annual Nasty Lukin Cup. What do you think of the performance so far? Anybody jumping off the page at you as somebody that could make that next step internationally?
Yes, it's an exciting competition. Of course, these are the best of the best, so it's fun to watch. But, you know, I just got finishing watching Faith Torres on floor, and her tumbling is really world. It's a world-class level. So looking for athletes that have that kind of potential. I noticed in the juniors, I'm also kind of thinking about, you know, beyond 2020. And a couple of athletes I've noticed have really excellent technique. Lily Bruce from World Champion Center, who's a teammate, I guess, to Simone at that gym. And a couple have really popped out.
Excellent. Let's talk about the U.S. national team. Big year coming up, World Championships in the fall. And obviously, everybody wants to know how Simone's doing as well.
She's doing well. Of course, you know, she's been busy. She won Sports Person of the Year. She's won some other awards, so she's trying to balance all of that with her training, doing an excellent job. We just finished a training camp that was in Florida. She looked great, so she'll be ready in Stuttgart to do a good job. I think she's really excited to try to do, I think, her fifth world champion all around. She motivates the team, so it's we're in good shape.
Awesome. Well, good luck the rest of the year. I know a lot of people will be watching you and Simone, of course. Back to you, Terry.
All right, John. We'll see Simone March 17th and that coverage there, Stuttgart. And, you know, talk about Tom. Marta Caroli was such a major figure for the U.S. women for a number of years. And now it's Tom Forster, who is the High Performance Director and leading the way with great talent, high hopes in the future on display tonight in Greensboro. An absolutely huge American flag here at the Nastia Lukin Cup. It's a big week in Greensboro and the young stars competing tonight. Jillian Hoffman, remember that first rotation? She led after the first rotation and now a share of fourth place. A 17-year-old from Murrieta, California.
So far tonight, 9.775 on vault and a 9.6 on the uneven bars. We've seen some of the athletes not be as steady on beam that are kind of in contention for this title. She's right there. She just needs to get a very big one out of the way right here.
Well, and you know, a lot of times, especially when you are kind of coming towards the end of the competition and you know that you have a chance to be on the podium or be in contention, that this is really where it becomes a mental game. All of these athletes are physically prepared. It is now who can be mentally tough.
And we'll find out right here. Really nice, first series. A back handspring into a laid out step out.
So far, so good.
Another aerial element, very nicely done. A little unorthodox, you don't see that often. A swing into a front flip, and that back tuck actually officially named a Corbett after Olympic great Olga Corbett. Dismount here. Coach is standing in, which is also okay. Nice, huge air. Beautiful double back. Somersault just kind of doubted herself. I think a little on the landing, ended up taking two steps forward.
You know, really looked like she was kind of going for the stick and tried to kick out of that double back a little bit too early. But what a gorgeous routine. Just rock solid from the very beginning. Tim, as you said, just showed so much confidence throughout.
You connect elements together. It's a series. This is a back handspring. She steps out and then jumps in the air, keeps her body straight, and lands 1 foot at a time, and that was beautiful.
Here's that skill that stood out to you, Tim. So basically a front toss to 2 feet, almost a front flip. But the way she took off was as if she was going to do a front aerial, but
dismount.
Did it in a tuck.
You see the coach standing in, no deduction for that. And then if she took a step forward with 1 foot, what you want to do is bring the other foot back together, not move the other one.
So 9-6, even 9-6 for Jillian Hoffman on beam. In third place, well positioned after that second rotation, Makari Daugett, the 18-year-old. Remember how long she had to wait before that floor routine.
But handled it truly like the veteran that she is.
Mentioned that high number, 985 on vault, highest number there all night.
Great air. Oh boy, that was close. Thought she might have put her feet down. Wasn't exactly where she wanted to be as she was reaching for that low bar. There's that double laid out somersault, and that was gorgeous. Beautiful body position. But I guarantee you, coaches, teammates, mom and dad, friends and family were holding their breath on that combination. Huge release and then transition down to the low bar. You'll see it here. The first one is just way up in the air, almost too high and almost a little too far away from the bar. Look, she's got to reach out, barely gets on, and has more swing than she typically would have. It's gorgeous there, but not in the spot she wanted to. She fumbled her hands, but what a great recovery right there.
And you see her heel actually did touch the mat in real time. We're not sure if the judges actually saw that. I didn't see it in real time, so we'll have to see what they do. But the dismount, she recovered so well. Just beautiful. And what you want to look for is those hips completely open, stretched, body position, chest up on the landing, stuck landing.
So that high number on vault, and now a 975.
So they definitely missed it.
They didn't catch it. Good catch on the replay, but nope. So still those high numbers, and remember, in the top three, and that's the highest number on the uneven bars we've seen tonight.
It is, absolutely.
She's over the beam.
Having quite a competition here.
And Sierra Brooks, who's currently in ninth place, heading into this third rotation. 17-year-old from the Chicago area.
Has committed to the University of Michigan. We asked her what her favorite event was, and she says it changes dependent upon the week. But right now, it's beam and bars.
You don't get that answer very often.
No,
that's truthful, though.
That's my standard answer. Literally, anyone asks me, it depends on the day.
You just don't want to give up any secrets. I know you.
No, it truly is. It depends on the day. It also depends on the time of the season. If you're doing routines, you probably have a different favorite event. When you're not in competition season and you're out there learning new skills, you might enjoy learning new skills on a different event.
And you know, there's all different kind of athletes that are competing here. A lot of gymnasts at some point, they want to go to world championships. They want to compete in Olympic Games. Her goal has been to be a collegiate gymnast, and she's going to be a fabulous one. Another one of those front tosses, a little bit of a balance check.
But beautiful combination. One of my favorite series on the balance beam, that handspring to two layouts in a row.
Are those two leaps in a row that the judges are looking for. I like that. Very playful. Double back. Oh boy, she had that. I thought she was gonna stick. Another really powerful athlete.
I know. Thank you.
Coach probably telling her the exact same thing. You had that.
I know. I was like, okay.
And here's that front toss at the beginning of the routine. So you see, her shoulders at the beginning, when she first lands, she doesn't seem completely off, maybe doubting herself, a little under-rotating the skill, which caused her to go off. But this series right here, she makes it look so easy, but I'm telling you, it is not easy. If you are the slightest bit off, the whole series is done.
This was great. Double back somersault, and sometimes you just stand up too quickly. If she had waited just a second longer, kept her arms out to counterbalance her, I think she could have come away with a stick, but a great routine nevertheless.
And there's the number, 9.7 for Sierra Brooks on the balance beam. John, you have more on her?
Yeah, you know, Sierra Brooks is having a great competition, but I was talking to her coach, Nick Becker. He's standing podium side during that balance beam, right before she went on that balance beam routine. I said, hey, Nick, do you coach her on beam? And he said, no, I don't actually. And I said, well, what do you tell her? He goes, whatever you do, don't listen to me. Just remember what your beam coach told you and stay calm. Well, apparently it worked. Back to you guys.
Worked tonight.
That's great. I mean, really, in reality, when these athletes are coming to a competition like this, they are so prepared that really all you really need to do is stay calm sometimes.
So over bars, Lindsay Batchelor, 15th place after that second rotation for the 15-year-old from Raleigh. You guys have mentioned how much talent there is here and how deep the field is for U.S. women around the world. Is there another country that would come close to the talent pool?
No, absolutely not. No, I don't think even close. I mean, China certainly has a lot of gymnasts doing the sport. Russia does too, but nobody has a system like the United States does, a feeder program of thousands of clubs all across America. I'll tell you, and the program was designed extremely well, and it just produces tremendous results and a huge pool of talent.
Agree with that, with your experience around the world?
Absolutely. I mean, as basically echoing exactly what Tim said, this the JO program, basically the Junior Olympic program that all of these athletes here are in today, is kind of that stepping stone, and it's a process. You start, you know, now I think level one, but when I was competing, it was level four, but, and you go all the way up to level 10, and then from level 10, you go into that elite scene, and there really isn't anything like that across the country.
Correct myself, though, Terry. There is a team that did have that depth, but it was did in the past. The Soviet Union also had that level of depth. Their system was unbelievably tremendous, and they produced many of the greatest Olympic and world champion gymnasts on both the men's and the women's side for many, many years.
Last couple of Olympic golds in terms of a team to the U.S. and the women's side, last four all-around golds at the Olympics as well. Here we go.
Release right here, nicely done. You're supposed to catch with straight arms. Ooh. Little bit of a fight in that handstand. She cast it up, and you're supposed to be exactly in that position, vertical. She was a little bit past, had to arch her back, which will be a deduction. Good recovery, but won't bring in the biggest score, that's for sure.
Sophomore in high school. About an hour and a half from here, depending on how heavy your foot is. All right, over to floor in eighth place after the second rotation, Maya Hudin, a 17-year-old from Minnesota, and you might recognize the music here if you listen to pop at all. Music, right? Beyonce. Okay. Maya Hudin, this 17-year-old who is a junior at Tartan High School, back at home and headed to the University of Minnesota. Get the number for her and continue with our coverage tonight. Nastia Lukin Cup from the Greensboro Coliseum. Back with a reminder, Florida swing time of the PGA Tour, PGA National, and they're facing the bear trap. Coverage of the Honda Classic continues tomorrow, 9 a.m. Eastern, PGA Tour Live, and 1 o'clock on Golf Channel, 3 o'clock on NBC. Meanwhile, Faith Torres getting ready on vault. John?
Yeah, a lot of buzz about Faith Torres. Obviously, Tim couldn't stop talking about her before the meet, and for good reason. She is qualified as an elite. She'll compete at the U.S. Championships later this summer. And talking to Andrea Lee, one of her coaches from Legacy Elite, she said she came to her a couple of years ago, and for the first year, all they did was train and try to upgrade her skills. And she said she basically came with no skills on bars. And for 2 years, they got those bar skills to the point where she can now compete as a senior elite. Quite a success story, and certainly somebody to watch in the next year and a half.
Yeah, Tim did kind of dominate that meeting with Faith Torres, talk, didn't he?
Straight out the gate, too.
For good reason.
I'll let her know you're a fan.
And she actually is right in the hunt right now. Makkari Doggett scored a 9.85 on vault. She needs that same score to be competitive. The thing she doesn't have going for her, though, is her vault starts at only a 10.0. Makari's vault did that extra half turn on it, had a 10.1 start.
Yeah.
So she needs to be uber perfect.
I don't want to confuse people with numbers. I just do want to point out, because we saw the routine, Maya Hooten on floor, 9.8. Huge number.
Very, very big number.
Yes. So we continue here in the third rotation of four for the young women. And you heard the bell and the announcement. So the warm-up is over. They get all the things in place. And we're going to start here with Faith Torres, as mentioned.
So she'll do what's called a Yurchenko-style vault, which is a half turn onto the board, go straight backwards, leave the vaulting table, and do a back laid out somersault with a full twist as a maximum score of a 10.0. Really needs to key in on the landing. And it was a beautiful vault. Little bit of closed hips as she's landing.
And she's actually capable of doing a much more difficult vault, adding a full extra twist to that. So a Yurchenko double twist, which she'll definitely want to use at the national championships later this year.
And I'm sure she will. You know, it's a very good vault. Gets her arms back pretty quick, a little bit high on the table. So doesn't get as much of a bounce off as she would like to, but really it's gonna come down to the landing.
And look right here, super quick, but her hands, as you said, just didn't quite get the repulsion. But you see where she lands, you see those two lines outside. Here's that second vault.
Oh, it was close, but I don't think she's gonna end up getting any more for that. Once again, she was a little bit high on the table. Kind of skims off of it. So the body should like jam into the horse. Arms should fly back and just explode right here. But her entire hand, I don't think, was down. It was just on the fingers of her hand that were touching.
All right, so 9.6 for the first one, 9.625, take the higher of the two, and that's the number for Faith Torres. You saw Anna Lee, one of her coaches, and drawn a smile after both of the efforts. Seems to be her approach, coaching-wise.
It's a good approach. Uh-huh. but really consistent, both of her vaults, you know, that's kind of what you're looking for. You don't want to have a drastic change.
And Anna's parents were exactly the same way with their coaching. You know, always happy, always smiling, very positive people. And so they become positive coaches.
Kaya Johnson, you saw her position after that second rotation. So right in the thick of things. In the mix and asking if they are ready.
Coach putting an extra mat, as we said, that is allowed in this competition.
John, what do you have?
Kaya Johnson's, one of her coaches is Kim Zemeskal-Verdet, a world champion, and I talked to her yesterday about Kaya, and she said she's so bummed not to be here because Kaya is actually graduating a year early to go to LSU, and she does not want to miss any of this young lady's senior year. She said she is an amazing leader, and she hates to be losing her from her gym, but she finished it with, watch out, because Kaya is on fire this year, and by the way, it had 3 exclamation points. That's good.
Kim, quite a gymnast herself, Olympic bronze, world champ.
An unbelievable athlete, and Kim is not taking the weekend off. She's actually in Italy with Team USA, and one of her gymnasts, Emma Malabuyo.
Thank you.
watched training yesterday and just even watching the competition, and I'm not just saying this because this is the 10th anniversary, but I really do feel like this might be one of the highest levels of competition and of gymnastics that we have seen at this Cup.
Spectacular, absolutely. As was her opening tumbling run, this is a double laid out somersault. So the way you get your body up into the air is you want to jam it into the ground as hard as you can, as much force right here, boom, into the ground. And that's what puts you into the air, just a small hop forward.
In her second tumbling pass, not as difficult as the first one, but you see she does, it's a combination pass. So back one and a half into a front half. But look at this, so much power, almost close out of frame.
What do you think that vertical jump was? Double pike somersault to finish it off. Really nice, lots of power once again. In JO rules, gymnastics, you are allowed to take that step back.
What do you make of this number?
I think it's too low.
Yeah, after what we have seen some of the other gymnasts achieve, you know, she opened the door just a little bit on the mount because she kind of took a hop and then maybe a little shimmy. And every time you do that, the judges, they can be brutal.
But not almost 4/10.
We just saw a 9.8 on floor a few moments ago. All right, we'll see what Madeline Johnston comes up with. Yes?
I would say yes. I mean, not as difficult, not as powerful as we have seen, but solid routine.
One hiccup in the middle, that double full forwards kind of got a little squirrely on the landing. But don't know what they're going to do with that score-wise because...
It's been hard to figure out tonight.
It has.
16-year-old from Maryland.
Come on, Mackenzie!
Going to Penn State, Madeline Johnston.
Once again, trains at Hills Gymnastics. Great longtime coach, Kelly Hill. So many tremendous athletes. I mentioned Dominique Dawes. So many others. Elise Ray.
Courtney Coupetz.
There's your answer number-wise.
Well, there it is, 9.6.
Well, I was looking for a reaction, but it was kind of, yeah. Okay, all right. Kind of
you know, and it's funny because
range.
A 9.6 is obviously a really great score, but our standards are clearly high here.
All right, we heard John talk to Tom Forster. He brought up this name, a 12-year-old Lily Bruce from Kingwood, Texas. That's where she is now. But originally in the hometown, right down the road, Chapel Hill, North Carolina.
I'm not quite, I'm pretty sure she might be able to walk underneath the low bar without bending over.
We've said that, of course, Reagan Smith. National team member.
But it's an important point because she's obviously a tiny person and those bars are really high for her. And when you have someone like that, it can be so difficult for them to deal with events like the uneven bars or even high bar.
Especially on those transitional, those release moves from low bar to high bar or from high bar to the low bar.
Yeah.
Just be a little bit more patient there. But definitely shows so much potential, a lot of promise. Big smile, and here's that dismount. So very difficult dismount, a double layout. So once again, as I've said, you want to look for those open hips in the air.
Check.
It literally just needed to bend her knee little bit more. Got a little too excited.
Yeah, and when they turn quick like that, salute the judges, they really don't fool anybody.
March 21st, 2006, that's when she was born. 12 years old, Lily Bruce. As we continue, three rotations in the books. Back to tell you, on Star Sunday, the NHL's biggest stars shine bright. First at 12:30 on NBC, the reigning Stanley Cup champs, Capitals, taking on the Rangers at the world's most famous arena. And then at 7:30, NBCSN Predators head to Minnesota to face the Wild. NHL Star Sunday presented by AT&T. We look ahead to this final rotation, the fourth rotation. Been interesting tonight. Big numbers from future stars. And Raina Worley, maybe a little bit of a surprise right now, leading the way over Makari Doggett.
Yeah, but she has had two gigantic events. Floor exercise was off the charts, and vault was tremendous as well. But that's nothing. 0.125, that's a toe point, you know, or one step backwards. And as Nastia, you alluded to this earlier, bars a lot of times for many of these gymnasts that are power gymnasts, great on floor, great on vault, it's typically not their best event. So we're gonna have to see how this plays out.
You know, it's always so fun because every single year it always comes down to the last event, the last dismount, the last up landing. And I feel like that's what makes this competition so fun, because it really is the best of the best. You don't know any single one of these athletes could win on any given day. It really depends who has the best day, who has the most duck landings.
So I'll get the highest numbers we've seen on two of the three routines that she has done. So it does come down to this fourth and final rotation in Greensboro. Getting set for this fourth rotation, the final run, and that title to be decided here. Terry Gannon, Nastia Lukin, Tim Daggett, John Roethlisberger, and the 10th edition of this event. Raina Worley, the leader after three rotations.
But it's close. It is really close. The top two, Raina is doing uneven bars. Makari Doggett is in second place. She's going to the beam. And the top scores on both of those events are exactly the same, a 9.75, and they've been evaluated pretty much the same throughout the competition.
So having said that, and it all does come down to individual, who feels better on what apparatus, but anybody have the advantage right now, you think?
To be completely honest, even if someone had an advantage on one day, it literally depends what happens in the moment, because they could both, as I just said before, they could both on any day probably come away with a title. It is going to come down to every single body position, every single cast handstand, every single step or movement of the feet on the dismount.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, with Raina, what she's obviously, she needs to hit the routine, got to catch releases, got to land the dismount. But as you mentioned, Nastia, every time her body is going up towards a hand, oh my goodness,
kind of
fell off the mat. I think the coach was moving the mat and
nothing.
All righty,
shake up your nerves a little bit.
Not exactly what you want to have happen, but you never know. Check this out here. So
see her coach moving the mat.
Pulls the whole mat and almost takes her out. And this could go either way. My guess is that it's going to help calm her down a little bit.
Yeah.
So look for the handstands, though. Exact vertical position from her hands, shoulders, hips, and toes. Right there. Excellent. Excellent again.
Great release. And here's another one down to the low bar. So far, this is a beautiful return. Oh!
and she covered it really well, but she was not supposed to fall that way. Opens up the book. The judges know that was not what she planned. Fights for that landing.
And you know, Tim, this is exactly what we were just talking about. She was fighting for those handstands, and that is what she was trying to do, was do every single handstand, land on top of the bar, and just missed it by just the slightest bit.
Going for it, though, absolutely going for it.
And it's not going to be a huge, huge deduction, but it definitely will be a little bit. So you see right here, she does a cast handstand and a half pirouette. She needs to land on the other side of the bar, covers it up nicely by doing an extra pirouette. No deduction for doing a full pirouette, basically, but also makes you pretty exhausted when you're adding extra elements to your routine that you're not used to.
She is. Full twisting, double somersault, two flips, one twist.
She was genuinely pumped up. She wasn't just selling it at the end.
Yeah, and this is real emotion, you know? I mean, she's worked her entire life as a gymnast. This is her reward. She's competing at the Nastia Lukin Cup. What could get better? And she's fighting for the lead.
Heading to the University of Kentucky from nearby Virginia. So while she was doing that, we had a routine from Sierra Brooks as things take place simultaneously here. And here is a look at this floor exercise.
Another huge talent right here.
So that was a short time ago. And the number for Sierra Brooks, 9.775. Another good score on floor, but how about the number? Disappointing one on uneven bars for Worley.
Yeah, she opened up the door. She had, you know, that handstand that was very, very iffy, and then definitely took a step at the very end of the landing, but it was really that one handstand. As a coach, though, and I'm sure she feels this way, I'm sure her coach feels this way, it's okay to make a mistake if you are absolutely going all out for it, and that's what she did. When you make a mistake and you're holding back, that is brutal.
Go back to bars right now. Gabby Gladio, 14-year-old, part of the junior competition here at home in Greensboro.
Beautiful handstand. As we said, that is what the judges are looking for. And every skill on top of the bar, hips open. Another great one right there.
That is a long way down for that young lady. A little short right there on the handstand. It'll be a tenth of a point. Blind landing, double front.
That wide-eyed look as the coach celebrated.
Nastia, you did that dismount.
Yeah, not my favorite. She did it great, though.
Yeah, very nice. Great form in the air, just a small step. I think this is the first one on air tonight that we've seen. A lot of the gymnasts are doing backward somersaults. This, she taps into that, changes her body's position to generate some power and just has to feel it in the air.
But she did it so well. You want to have your knees as close together as possible. I'm going to say that I did not do that. I got a lot for that, but it's really difficult to do that skill, especially landing what we call a blind landing. You're not able to see the ground when you're landing.
All right, meanwhile, on fall, Kaia Johnson, who was in fourth place, a quarter of a point off the lead going into this final rotation, needs a 9.6 and change to go ahead of Worley.
And that's very doable right here, without question. So if she does a Yurchenko-style vault and does a layout full, starts at a 10, adds an extra half turn, it's a 10.1 start. Oh boy, that was gorgeous. Just the full, though. Huge, huge power, though.
But I'm looking in front of me, and her coach is changing the start value. Basically, you have to flash your score at the end of the vault runway.
So watch this.
So it looks like she's going to do a different vault.
Just really bangs that vaulting table. Has plenty of time and a small little hop backwards. That was really good, and I'm surprised if they're going to do a different vault here. You see the 9.7.
Which is good enough to go ahead.
It is. You know, I would have thought that they would have just taken one more shot of that perfect landing, but
she's going for it.
She is. And like I said, when you're going big and you're giving it your all, that is exactly what you want. It's the perfect feeling in gymnastics. Oh,
just.
And yeah, and unfortunately, you know, that is going to get a lower score, but that is exponentially more difficult. A double twist.
But also, let's not forget, she has that 9.7,
uh-huh. Right.
And you will take the best score of the two, and that will absolutely be the best.
It's not the average, it's the best, better one of the two. On bars, Faith Torres, who is in third, less than a quarter of a point off the lead going into the final rotation.
That first handstand, that pirouette, was a little bit short. Some leg separation there.
Hard to see, though, for the judges that are on the side. We're a little skewed. Big release elements, though. Legacy Elite, always known for really great, exciting bars.
But of the four events, and I think we've said this so many times tonight, but we have been so impressed with her on all the events. And if she lacks somewhere, it would be right here on the uneven bars. But the other three events were just spectacular.
A lot of really tough stuff in that exercise, though. Just not as clean, all these major releases. Like you said, Nastia, you said you saw the legs come apart, but we're looking at it not from the side, and the judges are positioned exactly at the side. A lot of times people see, you know, when it's shot differently, they see those legs are apart, and the judge really can't see that.
But what they can see are those handstands.
Oh,
that,
yeah.
That first one that she had was a little bit low. Again, they judge a little bit easier on the level 10 scene, but in the lead, it would definitely be a huge deduction.
Really wanted to nail that dismount, kind of closed her hips a little bit, which caused her to rotate a little faster and ends up taking that definite step.
Needs a 9.68 to go ahead of Johnson. 9.5 is what she receives.
She's got a lot to be proud of, though. She's a tremendous athlete, has come so far, so fast in her career.
Good.
So the senior competition coming down to that, the final couple of efforts here in the rotation.
Good.
The junior competition continues with the 15-year-old from Utah, Kylie Equinto.
You know, we end up saying this about almost all of the gymnasts now, but they typically get started at a local club program, and it's a parent-child program for her. It was a mommy and me. Mom took her there, and they both participated in gymnastics, and she has stayed with it and had a great career thus far.
Many times because mom and dad think you've got too much energy.
Absolutely.
You got to channel that somewhere.
A solid routine, double pike mount was stratospheric and just a perfect landing on it. She's wearing pink, so she is a junior competing here. Distinctly different competitions.
15-year-old freshman in high school, Kylie Ekinto, among those still to come. Makari Doggett on beam. So the warm-up concluding here. And the announcements, too. They're having some fun here in Greensboro, apparently. So are we, down to this final rotation and everything on the line here, the 10th edition of the Nastia Lukin Cup. Guys, it's been close. It's been impressive.
Yeah, it typically is, as we have said, and that's exciting. You know, I mean, the 10-0 scoring system, it can create really close competitions and, you know, sometimes some parity, which isn't bad in sport, that's for sure.
And it's been, kind of been like this throughout the decade.
It absolutely has, but I don't know. To me, that's what makes it so exciting, and I think it makes it exciting, probably more nerve-wracking for the athletes, but for us here on the other side, in the TV world, it definitely makes it exciting because it comes down to the last dismount, not even the last routine, because you could have an amazing routine, take one step on landing, and there's your second place or first place finisher.
Getting ready for that final rotation. It's been a meaningful and emotional night for Natalie Martin, the 13-year-old from Ohio. You heard John tell you early tonight that her dad is at home battling cancer, and some question as to whether or not she would be able to compete here, but he wanted her to be here and wanted her to compete. She and her mom are here in her final rotation now, and she will compete on beam.
The dreaded balance beam.
But you know, I think despite how she finishes here, just for her to be able to come out here, put a smile on her face like she has, and not just here in the competition, but when I got to see her yesterday and today, to be completely honest, I had no idea about her father until the competition, and you would have never known just such a strong character and you know, just doing it for her father.
Yeah, I bet, you know, she's smiling, but I bet dad at home is beaming. And, you know, we wish him well in his struggles. Good fight. One of those feet on the beam kind of squirmed a little bit as she made contact, but didn't lose her composure, which is so critical.
A little off, and you see those. A lot of times, these balance checks aren't necessarily because you're off. Yes, of course, sometimes that does happen, as we all know, the beam's only 4 inches wide, but a lot of times it is the confidence, those extra nerves, the adrenaline. Beautiful right there.
Very nice.
But what I like to try to do, at least when I was competing,
on the beam was to pretend that I was doing my routine on the floor exercise, that this wasn't a beam that was 4 inches wide, but I had the entire floor. So you're always confident there.
Double twist, done in combination, which makes it much more difficult. Very nice job. Lot to be proud of, this young lady.
Well done for the eighth grader from Westerville, Ohio. Natalie Martin. We certainly wish her and her family the best in the coming days.
Saw a lot of grit with her, too. Remember I said, wasn't exactly on this. What? Let's watch her feet as they meet the beam. And from this angle, makes me look like, you know, I'm out to lunch. But from the other angle, or from the angle I was watching her, one of those feet almost slipped off.
There's that front toss once again. Beautiful. And really, she does look like she's just performing that on the floor exercise.
And when you do it, the dismount in combination from two back handsprings like this, it makes it so much more difficult. The timing is critical.
So a 9.425 for Natalie Martin. And we go from one young teenager to another, a 12-year-old, not yet a teenager. Lily Bruce. Also, obviously, in the junior category here.
Here we go. Oh, little bit off, but beautiful extension of the legs and feet in the air on that. I can't even imagine. She's growing up in a gym with not just the current Olympic and world all-around champion, but the greatest of all time. I can't even imagine. Oh.
Whoa.
And that was an amazing save.
You know, and a lot of times, these younger athletes, when they're not as experienced, they would have just jumped off, you know? And that really is so important, to fight for every single skill or landing, even if you're a little bit off. Not off there. That was great.
Yeah, that was
great.
Beautiful. Oh, boy. Coach Cecile.
And here's that opening series, those two elements in a row. Just as you said, Tim, gorgeous extension, but just over-rotated a little bit.
But what a fight right here. I mean, she is so off. Look at those toes. They are squeezing that beam. They could probably crack walnuts. So watch the feet here. And those toes, they squeeze and they fight and grab on like talons.
But that dismount, so a lot easier than we've seen pretty much all night. So a round off and you see a 1.5 twist. What makes this so difficult is she cannot spot the floor until her feet are physically on the ground. So you really have to make sure that you have great technique from the punch all the way to the landing.
It's a lot of trust you have to have in yourself and the landing. 9.4 for Lily Bruce as we check in with John.
Yeah, thanks, Terry. Tim, you had mentioned having the opportunity to train in the gym with the greatest of all time. And I found it interesting talking to Cecile Andy yesterday about that. And she said one of the best things isn't what Simone does great. It's what she struggles on. And the girls get a chance to see her on those days when she's not good and how she reacts to the difficulties of the sport of gymnastics. And she says they may learn more from that than anything else. I thought it was pretty unique.
That's a great comment, and because it's exactly true. Even the very best have their struggles.
All right, from the junior level, we take you over to the floor and the senior level. Jillian Hoffman in a share of fifth place after the third rotation. But when you look at the numbers right now, she would need a 9.775 to take the lead. It would actually tie Kaya Johnson, but she would win the tie break. So that number, keep that in mind as she's out there.
And we have seen that number on floor, but not a lot of them, that's for sure. Best number so far, 9.85 from
Raina Worley on the floor exercise.
They do break the tie, by the way, with the highest single event score. And it would go to Jillian Hoffman. So here's the 17-year-old from California getting set.
Which, by the way, I'm not a fan of, the whole
tie break.
Yeah. Don't get me started on that.
We've discussed that.
Did you ever tie in a major competition, maybe on even bars at the Olympic Games? I don't know. It was a wonderful moment, and you were both incredible champions. He Kaxin from China ended up winning that tiebreaker, but in my book and many people's other books, you are co-Olympic champions with Kaxin from China.
Thank you, Tim.
I was wondering.
I'm sorry. But,
yeah. It's like, how do I get a compliment around here?
I'm sorry. I was thinking.
You were flashing back, weren't you?
I was. I just remember being confused. To be completely honest, I remember looking at the score, and we had the exact same score, and there was a one next to her name and
like,
a two
why
next
am I
to
two?
I'm like, wait a second.
Maybe my competition will be a qualifier next year. I don't know.
Once again, you have to apply, so I'll let you know if you
just
get in.
Just joking, of course.
This is a long wait.
This is.
All right, tension now broken.
Unbelievable.
I don't know. I've said all night long that it will come down. The crowd is going wild.
Yeah,
the
whole cheering section. Yes.
And she loves them.
From looking at what we've seen tonight, I would say that's good enough. There's nothing better in the world than in the biggest moment of your life going out and doing the best routine you're capable of.
I have goosebumps for her. That was phenomenal.
Remember, 9.775 is what she needed. Now, in the exact same position after the third rotation, Gabby Wilson. Gabby and Jillian had the exact same number going into this fourth.
Nice piked front somersault or Jaeger. This mount here, double layout. Nice needed, landing.
Needed a big effort there because midway through you heard the cheer.
Yes.
You didn't see the number, but you heard the cheer from the cheering section. Gabby Wilson. And a share of fifth going into that final rotation. But the number came up. Yeah, 9.9.
Wow.
Jillian Hoffman into the lead she goes.
I mean, you're that close to a 10, just give it to him.
I knew you were going to say that, and I agree. In a competition this, the landings were off the charts fantastic.
Makari Doggett now, the veteran here, needs a big effort on Beam. Remember, she was in second after the third rotation.
Solid. It's always Beam to me was at least the most nerve-wracking, most stressful event to end on, especially when you are in the position that she is in, knowing you have a chance, but that's the last thing that you should be thinking about.
From the Broadway Challenge on floor exercise.
Well, she certainly has been doing her job. Oh boy, legs apart, hops backwards and then to the side. And that landing, as we've said, could absolutely be the difference.
Makari Doggett, the veteran here, so many times at this event and waiting for a number to see if she can win it. Remember where she was going into the final rotation. She was in second. The two names, two athletes we just saw, Hoffman and Wilson, were in fifth, the share of fifth, that big number, 9.9 for Hoffman. So Doggett needs a 9.705.
Yeah, I don't think she can get it. I mean, it was an excellent routine. Really, the last element, that dismount, you know, she takes a step back and then to the side. Those are two separate deductions. Her legs are also a little bit apart. And psychologically, the judges, the last thing they see.
Oh, look at the number, 9.8. Wow, 9.8 from Makari Doggett, and that is enough.
I don't even think she knows right now.
She is the winner. I'm not sure she knows.
Yeah, and I got that wrong, obviously.
There, listen.
I won?
She just found out.
Wow.
And it seemed like a complete surprise in that moment. Makari Doggett.
I'm sorry.
The 18-year-old from Ohio. And the final result, she's the winner. Doggett, Hoffman, Kaya Johnson rounding out the top three. And look at how close it was. And she is with John right now.
Thank you, Makari. Sixth time is the charm, right? What does this mean to you?
It means everything. I would have never believed. I just came here to have fun with all these teammates, and this is a dream come true. Wow.
You were standing at that podium for a long time waiting for your turn. What did your mom tell you and what was going through your head?
Just to do what I do in the gym and have fun, because no matter what, that's all it's about. And that's what I did. I just went up and I had fun, and I can't control the results, so yeah.
Congratulations, your career is complete. Good luck at Alabama. Back to you, Terry.
Roll Tide, I guess. She came here for what reason? Remember earlier tonight?
Because she liked the leotard.
The Leo. That's not the only thing she's going home with. She is the winner, Makari Doggett, and it comes down to so close in the end. We wrap things up. Coverage continues at the FIG World Cup in 2 weeks on Olympic Channel and NBCSN. Thanks, everybody, for watching the 2019 Nastia Lukin Cup. It's been terrific for Nastia Lukin, Tim Daggett and John Roethlisberger, our entire crew. I'm Terry Gannon saying so long for now from Greensboro.